Hi everybody, it's Dr. Doyle. Today I am here with one of my favorite Marvel characters, Wanda. And if you've seen WandaVision or any of the Marvel movies, the Avengers that has Wanda in it, you may know one of her signature moves is to get really angry, have fire come from her hands and fly up in the air. We're going to do some experiments here today with some pulleys to see how the movie production may have been able to accomplish that. So let's get some pulleys. All right, welcome back. Here we have Wanda on her rig. Now I've added a string to it. And here's what's going to happen. Wanda's going to go on set. She's going to be all rigged up. She'll be doing her scene. And at the moment when she gets angry, she is lifted up. And that pulley helps the people backstage to lift her up. But how much force do we need to apply to this rope to get her to lift up? That's what we're going to look at. To measure that, I'm actually going to take this string, run it through this second pulley, and then attach it to this spring scale here. And that spring scale is going to read for us the amount of force needed in this string to get us to pull and support Wanda in this fixed position. While I'm getting her all rigged up, I recommend that you draw a free body diagram here of this pulley and see if you can figure out what the weight, the force in this pulley will be. Okay, so here's Wanda rigged up in this one pulley situation. I know it looks like two pulleys, but you'll see in a moment here what I mean when I say multiple pulleys. So Wanda's held in her equilibrium position up flying in the air, and you can read this spring scale here, and I'll zoom in on that for you, show a little picture, and it is reading right at a little bit less than 2.0 newtons. Okay, so remember again, this whole rig is about 0.2 kilograms or 200 grams.
All right, so there's Wanda following that string, going up to this spring scale, and you can see here that it is a little bit less than 2 newtons. So now I'm going to utilize this double pulley here so that we can put Wanda into different configurations. You'll see the first thing I'm going to do, and you can look at this all in your handout, is I will have Wanda hanging from this double pulley. And the first thing I'm going to do is support her with two strings. Wanda. You can see I'm going to take Wanda and utilize this double pulley. Stick this through here, and then the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to support Wanda with two going up on two sides, and then we're going to do some winding. This is all in your handout, and as we do each step, please go ahead and don't drop Wanda, don't drop your talent. Go ahead and try to draw the free body diagrams for each of the scenarios, as well as try to do some of the statics. What happens when we increase the number of pulleys that we are using? All right, so here is situation B. We're going to draw the free body diagram there in a minute, but here I have my one pulley and I have attached it to the spring scale, and then it's just hanging from what would be the ceiling. And down here, I am going to attach Wanda. Wanda's rig has seen better days, so let's see how she does. Okay. There is our Wanda. I'm going to make sure that I have this lined up pretty well. And now I can read my spring scale here, and that spring scale is reading just under 1 newton this time. Okay, I've got this all rigged up. I have the same string coming from my spring scale through this upper pulley, over this pulley, and then connect it back to there. So let's rig up. So think about what the free body diagram of that would look like. Try drawing that on your handout, and then let's see what happens when we put Wanda in her rig on here. Okay. Hope Wanda's giant head is not impacting our results. So if we read the spring scale on this one, we will see that it is about 0.66, maybe 0.75. here's our Wanda. Okay, so again, go ahead, draw that free body diagram. See if you can write the equilibrium equations. We'll do that all together in a minute, or I'll do that for you in a minute. And then we'll rig up the very last scenario, scenario D. Y'all, this is feeling very precarious. So here we are. I have one string, and it's attached to my spring scale. It goes through this bottom pulley, up over this big pulley, through the top pulley of my double pulley, and then is attached here. Let's add Wanda in her rig. Goodness. Okay. Rig, do your magic. There she is. There is our Wanda. Wow, she needs to stay off. There. Okay, so what is my spring scale now reading? It's just above 0.5. So we'll take a snap photo of that for you to see. So can you draw a free body diagram? For all these free body diagrams, you're drawing a free body diagram just of the double pulley. So thinking about isolating this double pulley like we did when we worked our free body diagrams last week, and looking at the free body diagram for just the double pulley. Can ignore what's happening at the spring scale and anywhere else that this is attached to or going over any pulleys. So take a moment, draw those free body diagrams for each of these scenarios, and then write out some equations of equilibrium and let's see what's happening. Okay, I'm going to leave Wanda hanging up here for forever. And let's go ahead and draw some free body diagrams. So I've already shown that one for each of our three scenarios. I've already shown that Wanda is hanging down from each of our double pulleys, and I'm going to replace that with red arrows to represent forces. So we can just have it as the force of Wanda if we want to. Here is Wanda. So for B, if you can recall, and I'll show that photo up here again, we just had two forces going up. So it was the string was going through just the top part of this double pulley. And we're going to represent that just as two forces going up. Now remember what happens with pulleys. Because this is all one string, it goes down through the bottom of here. We're going to have T and T. Okay, so next thing you can do is write the equations of equilibrium for this. And if we do that, we're going to sum the forces in the Y. No forces in the X, so we can ignore that. And we have 2T is equal to Wanda. Now, this Wanda includes the total mass of the rig and everything. So our tension is Wanda over 2. Look back at the video and see if that matched up. Let's move on to C. So in this particular case, we had Wanda coming down. And I hope that you all can see this okay. Anyway, I can always crop it a little bit. So I had Wanda going down, and I had three tensions going up. So if you can remember on this one, the string came down from the spring scale, went around here, back up. Let me double check that. Back up, and then yeah. Okay, so if you can remember on this one, the string started up the spring scale, went down around the bottom one, back up around another pulley that we are not super interested in, and then came back and attached here. So this means that if we again, same string, because when it went above that pulley up there, we didn't break it into another string. It wasn't tied off. It's that same string, so our same roll of pulleys holds. So in this case, we sum the forces in the Y, set them equal to 0. And now 3T equals Wanda. And T is equal to Wanda over 3. Okay, and then our very last scenario, scenario D. Okay, scenario D here.
tension, went above another one, came down here, that's going to pull up still, and then it came and attached to that other one. So I have four T's. So in this case, the sum of the forces in the Y equals zero. 4T is equal to lambda, so T is equal to lambda over 4.
Okay, so what does this tell us about pulleys?
So this tells us that when we can use the rule of pulleys, that when you have the same string and it goes through a pulley, the tension remains constant in the string. We can use that to our advantage, and the more pulleys that you can go through, the more mechanical advantage you're going to add to your system. So in this case, the rig being used to pull up and hold Wanda above the ground only needs to support a quarter of her weight. Versus if you just have one pulley in the very first scenario, you're going to need to hold her with the full weight of Wanda and the rig. So you can see that with the use of multiple pulleys, it's going to give you a significant mechanical advantage. We saw that here with just looking at different configurations of pulleys in our lovely Wanda model. Thanks, Wanda. The last thing we're going to do here is just solve a problem. So before you watch me solve the pulley problem, please take a